Let's meet the Fichera family. Paul, Pat, Lisa, Marie, and Glenn, ready for action. Playing against the Warner family. Scott, Rebecca, Carol, Denise, and Kevin, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cope.
Thank you so very much. Welcome to Family Feud. Thank you for joining us at home. I have to take just a second. All too often, I forget. We get the greatest families. We give away cash, but we forget to thank these wonderful studio audiences. And we're overflowing. We've turned away a couple of hundred people here today. When you come to town, we appreciate you coming down and standing in line. To all the people who are standing in the back again, we love you, and God bless you. Right now, let's get along with the show. Our returning champions, the Fichera family. We could give them a big ovation. Paul? Have you ever seen such? I have never seen, but, you know, people could go see Family Ties, they could go see Cosby, or other, but they've waited in line for hours, and it brings a tear to my eye that they're here tonight to watch the taping.
Certainly. Family.
Paul, your family has won $10,912. Is this your family?
Family.
Who'd you bring with you to help you return?
I brought my wife, Pat.
Hi, Pat.
My son, Glenn.
Howdy, Glenn.
Hi, Ray.
His wife, Lisa.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi, Ray.
And Pat's mother, Marie.
Hello, Marie.
Hi,
welcome back to Family Feud. You're playing against a sharp-looking family. Let's say hello to the Warner family. Hello.
Hi.
Good to see you. We've got an enthusiastic crowd. Are you you're really eager to win the Bucks?
You bet we are.
You're going to have to play sharp, and you're going to have to come more alive than that. This family is, well, I don't want to say unscrupulous, but they have done it. Glenn has admitted to wearing a bra. Paul went across against his family and said ice cubes. Marie has really done much of nothing, but she's with the family and she's going to get part of the cash. And we love her, but you have to be willing to give of yourselves. Who did you bring to give of yourselves for the money?
I brought a hot group. This is my wife, Denise.
Hi, Denise.
Hi.
Try to calm down. I can feel the hotness coming off of them.
My mother, Carol.
Hi, Carol.
Hi.
My sister, Becky.
Hi, Becky.
Hi, Ray.
And my brother-in-law, Scott.
All right, I know you'll loosen up. God will help you. Are you ready, Kevin?
I'm ready.
I say, let's play the feud! Paul and Kevin. The first family to $300 will win the game, get a chance to play fast money for the $5,000. Good luck, Kevin. Be ready to smack. Paul's been here before. We asked 100 people this question, and we have the top 8 answers on the board. Try to find the most popular. Name something you've bought that you couldn't afford. Paul.
My automobile.
Paul's automobile. All right. What kind do you have?
BMW.
You have a BMW? Show me an automobile. Tis number one. You know what? You have, come here, Paul, real fast. I've seen thousands in the 10 years I've been doing this show. I've seen a lot of techniques of smacking. There's the sneaky kind. There's the coming from Cleveland kind. But your kind, do it. Just watch his technique. It's kind of like, I got it, and he slides away.
It's a show secret.
Let's see. See that? It says slide. It's kind of like, no, I'm coming at you, pal. All right, Paul, it's a great technique. Pat, welcome back.
Hi.
Good to see you.
Nice to be back.
It's my pleasure. We have the second most popular answer there. Something you've bought that you couldn't afford.
Jewelry.
Ooh, people do it all the time. Show me jewelry. Number 3, said by 12. I was teasing earlier, but
it's okay.
But people that were watching the show, I asked a question of place where you hide money, and instinctually you said, in my bra. You said that?
I did.
I think we found your bra. You dropped it backstage.
Yeah.
We'll see if we can find that later. Okay. Something you've bought that you couldn't afford?
Number 2 answer, a house.
Yes.
Sadly. Sadly today, anytime you buy a house, you can't afford it, no matter what. Yeah. All right. Glenn. You live in Santa Barbara?
Yeah.
And it's very. What's the average house cost up there?
About $300,000.
And then you get a husband trying to drive a BMW.
Right.
an old one. Yeah. Son wearing a bra. You've got a lot of problems. Counseling. You add all those bills up.
Bills. Yeah.
Let me see a house. Yeah. You said it was number 2 and it was. Lisa.
Hi, Ray.
He said it was number 2. Can you predict which answer you're going to give?
I think number 4 or 5, and I will say a fur coat.
Okay.
Lisa says it's number 4 or 5. Show me a fur coat. Oh. Marie, let me tell you something. Now, I was teasing earlier. We love you, and we think you're awfully sweet and special. And when I was standing over there being a smart aleck, and I said that you've done nothing to contribute to the family, I was kidding. Because from your sweetness alone, you have brought this family up.
Oh, thank you so much.
Now, you will give me an answer, and you'll show your worth.
Come on, Mother.
Name something you've bought. A boat?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
A boat. Yeah.
See, Marie? Lovely Marie says a boat. There it is. It's a great answer. Paul, do you know number 3?
It's already up there.
Paul, don't ever embarrass me in front of my friends again. This is my show, and I knew it, okay?
How long have you been doing this, Ray?
Paul, I didn't say anything about that tie, okay? Don't you make fun of my number 4.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. I did make a mistake, and I make a few. What? Crowd can turn against you. This is the kind of crowd to become a mob, Paul.
I forgot what I was going to say.
I'll try to talk you through it. Something you bought that you couldn't afford.
An entertainment center. Your home, like TV, stereo.
Okay, all right. The judge has, every once in a while the judge gets riled and you riled him, Paul. He says one answer and one answer
only. I'm sorry, entertainment center.
He says an entertainment center. You could have got mad because you were picking on me. I don't know. All right. Show me entertainment center. Good try, Paul. That's 2 strikes. Pat?
Close.
There are 2 strikes if clothing is not there. They are going for the steal. Let me see clothing. 7 people said it. No pressure, Glenn. The Warners waiting to steal. Sure, they look quiet, but they're waiting to steal the bank right from you.
Okay. A stereo system.
If it's there, you are... You cannot say that. Your papa already said stereo system. Can you give me another one?
A motorcycle.
A motorcycle. They're sometimes expensive, and if it's there, you're still alive. Motorcycle. Third strike. Warners? One answer that will steal that bank. Name something you've bought that you couldn't afford. Scott.
Television.
A television. Rebecca.
Furniture.
Furniture. Carol.
Motorhome.
A motorhome. Denise.
Furniture.
Furniture. Kevin, you can take any of those answers or go out on your own. There are 3 there. If you give me one,
what'd you say,
stole
Becky?
Stole the bank.
Furniture.
Becky says furniture.
Furniture.
You go with Becky.
I go with Becky.
And his wife.
And his wife. Did you say it too?
Oh, okay. Good job.
I'm sorry.
Good job, Mike.
I don't mean to cause any kind of family feuds here. It's there. Well, it was a joke. If furniture's there, you got the bank. If not, it goes to the Fichera family. Let me see some furniture. Now, you steal the bank. You take the $81. There are 2 answers we did not know. Show us number 7. Stereo. No one in this family said it, but they could have and stole the bank, even though Glenn tried to give it. Paul inadvertently gave 2 answers. You can only give one. Your first answer is used, and you're...
Listening.
And the other family members are not allowed to use it. Number 8. Computer. We are coming right back, and you're going to keep learning a lot of great things if you stay tuned, so don't go away.
Your hands sweat. Your legs ache as you race to victory. And all this for a 4-foot salami. Supermarket Sweep, weeknights at 8:30.
Welcome back to Family Feud, and we've got a feud. The Warners have $81, challenging our champions. The Ficheras, 0. Let's go. It's time for another pace-up. Pat? Denise? Before we go, now, Denise, I noticed when your husband looked a bit tired. What time did he get home last night? His eyes. I was up. What time did he get in?
Late.
Well, how late is late? Give me an answer, quick. Listen, not a minute,
sir. I was asleep.
You were asleep. What time did he tell you? Never pick your nose on camera. Oh, what time did he tell you, do you think? I said, hold your hand down if you have to.
2.
He said 2. We'll talk more about this in a moment. I don't know if we should trust him. Where did he say he was?
Ventura.
Not the old Ventura story. All right, we'll talk more about this. Good luck. We've got the top 5 answers on the board. Name someone famous with the name Ford. Denise?
Glenn.
How about Glenn Ford? He's there, but there are 4 answers. Give you control, Pat. What do you say?
President Ford.
Can we say President Ford? He's number 2. Think of the steal, Denise. Glenn, we found this right by your dressing room, pal. I don't know. And what's worse, there was $50 hidden right in there, Glenn. We kept the cash, but this is for you. You can wear it as a crown.
Thanks. Thanks.
It's kind of a Dolly.
Put it on a little bit later.
Dolly Parton crown. That's it. Pilot to co-pilot. We're coming in for a landing.
Great for cold nights,
that's
you know.
It. It's kind of like, yeah, that's it. Never mind. Forget it. All right. Name someone famous with the name Ford.
Henry Ford.
Gotta be.
Henry!
Yeah! Yeah. 39 people. Lisa?
I will say Gerald's wife, Betty Ford.
Yeah! Yes. Great first lady. And a hell of a clinic, I'll tell you that. Show us Betty Ford.
Yeah!
9 people said it. Runners, you better try to think of a steal. Marie, you can bring it home for the family. That means you can actually take the bank. I'll translate that if you give me number 4. Don't pray. Name a famous Ford. 3 seconds.
William Ford.
William Ford, I'll say that. Now, I know that he could be there, and probably a lot of the younger people in the crowd wouldn't know what Bill Ford did. And if you wouldn't mind telling all of us what William Ford was most famous for.
That was Henry Ford's brother.
Yeah, okay. Henry Ford's brother, all right. He was kind of like robot.
He was the younger brother.
He was the younger brother who didn't quite get all the fame that his brother did. So he probably, Bill Ford was
so
his name.
I thought perhaps I could help him.
A lot
along.
Of people, it is true. I knew that. And of course, our judge, being the historian that he is pointing out that is in fact true. But did it make our survey?
Sure.
Show me Bill Ford. Okay, surprisingly. Bill didn't make the survey. Did you know him or date him in any way, Marie? Hey, calm down out there. I'm just asking some questions here. This crowd, I'll tell you what, Paul. These are your relatives, aren't they? Got one strike.
Edsel Ford.
Edsel Ford. If it's there, the bank is yours. How about Edsel Ford? Okay, a little pressure, Pat. They're going for the steal if you can't give me number 4.
Repeat the question one more time.
Name someone famous named Smith.
One famous. Okay. John Ford.
You say something, Pat. You lied about
directly.
It. You already. It's fine. I'm not making fun of that. You knew the question.
No, I wanted to know if it was someone or something.
Well, I read a whole different question. And you still answered the Ford question. You say John Ford, and he is famous. Right. And if it's there, that bank is yours. Show me John Ford.
Oh.
That was a nice try. Didn't make our survey, but can you tell me a famous Ford?
Harrison Ford.
Someone famous named Ford. Scott says Harrison.
Harrison Ford.
Harrison. Denise.
Okay, I'll be different. Eileen Ford.
Kevin, you've got a couple of choices, or you can always go out on your own. You are the head of this family.
Yes, I am.
What are you going to do? What is number 4?
I'll go with the family.
What is that?
What'd you guys say?
Are you going to go with Harrison Ford? You're too tired, I think, to actually go out on your own.
Yes.
All right. He says, I think you're too tired to make a decision.
Okay.
2 o'clock in the morning?
Harrison.
Ventura?
Yes, it was.
We don't want to talk about it. We'll find out more about this. If Harrison is there, that bank is yours. If not, the Ficheras have the bank. Show me Harrison. $170. You've got to go all the way to $300 to play for $5,000. We're coming right back. We're feuding the Warners, $170, challenging the Ficheras with 0. Let's go! The dollar value is doubled. We've got the top 6 answers on the board. We asked 100 people, name an occasion on which you take a lot of pictures. Glenn.
Christmas.
How about Christmas? It's there. Before you say it, Carol, there are 3 answers that will give you control.
Weddings.
How about a wedding? Numero uno. Warners, you can win if you take this question, Rebecca.
Vacation.
How about your vacation? Number 2. Scott. First time down there, I think, officially.
Yeah. Yeah.
Got an answer?
Reunion.
Good answer.
Is that specific enough? We'll say reunion. There we go. 2 people said it. 2 answers away from winning the game, Kevin.
Graduation.
A graduation.
Yeah!
Was he out too late to give me a right answer? Show me graduation. Bingo!
Yeah!
1 answer, Denise, and you're playing for $5,000. But before you say it, don't say it. I don't want you to give it to me because I want to say one thing. I've done thousands of these shows, and I know you're probably upset that he came in late, but you've masked it beautifully here today. You seem so sweet and charming, and you believe that story about Ventura and 2 in the morning. Kevin, is that really where you were at 2 in the morning? What were you doing?
No,
time?
I was driving back from Ventura. Got home at 2.
And it was a business deal?
Yes.
All right, a business deal. And you closed it, and you made money?
Yes, I did.
The check comes through.
Okay.
Yes, I did.
Okay. Denise, yes. You have kids?
Yes.
Oh, I forgot what I was going
to
say.
Oh, no. Four?
Four. Oh. Go ahead. 4 kids, 3 boys and a girl.
That is 4. Thanks, Kevin. A lot. And I'm sure they're very handsome. All right, here we go, Denise. It's all resting on your shoulders. There is one answer there. If you give it to me, you're going to be the champions and you're going to play fast money. Name an occasion on which you take a lot of pictures.
Birthday parties.
She says a birthday party, Judge. That's a great, great, great. You know, what's the thing with your nose, Denise? Why, is your nose cold? Because you keep passing it. Let me just rub it for you real fast. It's going to warm up if birthday party's there because you're going to play for $5,000. Show me birthday party. Thank you. The Ficheras, you've got a lovely family car. You've got over $10,000. Thank you for being on our show. You've played so well. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. I need 2 players for $5,000. Who's playing? Come on, Devin. Who's playing first? Bye-bye. The Warners, our new champions. Playing fast money with Rebecca right after the Muscle Group Show.
$1,095 stereo system for $6.
It's time to go shopping.
One of these teams may be going home with $5,000.
I can't breathe.
Program that works and is easy? Try the South Beach Diet. Save 50%. What are y'all waiting for?
Go online to the link below to claim this special overnight deal.
Time's a ticket. Go online right now.
Go online right now to save 50% plus get keto-friendly shakes free.
If you are ready, 15 seconds on the clock, please. The time will begin after I finish reading the first question. Good luck. How many times would you pay to see a movie you really enjoyed?
2.
A word you hear in a poker game.
Full house.
Speak up. A woman's name that starts with E.
Ellen.
The most comfortable room temperature.
70.
A bookstore chain.
Dalton.
Turn around. That was 5. You got shy on me and you came around. How many times would you pay to see a movie you really enjoyed? You said 2 times. Our survey said 55 people would pay 2 times. A word you hear in a poker game. You must have played a lot of poker. You just shouted this out.
Played.
Never played? You said full house. Our survey said 12 people. A woman's name that starts with E. Your choice? Ellen. Our survey said 25 to 92. The most comfortable room temperature you said was 70 degrees. Our survey said it was 31 people agreed. A bookstore chain, you said? Dalton Books. Our survey said 33 up to 156. Wonderful. Back with your family. And here comes Kevin. All right, Kevin.
Oh, yeah.
You need 34 points, my friend. Look straight ahead for $5,000. I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions I asked your teammate. If you hear this sound, it means you should never stay out to 2 o'clock in the morning and use that Ventura story. No, it means you duplicated her answer. I'll say try again, and you give me another answer. You ready?
I'm ready.
It's a little more difficult, so 20 seconds on the clock, please. Revealing your partner's answers, you can do it. How many times would you pay to see a movie you really enjoyed?
2.
Try again.
3 times.
A word you hear in a poker game.
Craps.
A woman's name that starts with E.
Esther.
The most comfortable room temperature.
72 degrees.
A bookstore chain.
Crown.
Turn around here, you need 44 points. I'll tell you one thing, you had some interesting answers. How many times would you pay to see a movie you really enjoyed? Don't laugh at yourself, you said 3 times. Our survey said 23. Yeah. The number one answer was 2 times given by your partner. I don't think there's any chance you're going to bring it home on this. I asked you a word you hear in a poker game, you said craps.
I don't play.
I don't know that it's obvious that you don't play. That's a whole nother game. If 21 people said craps, you've got the cash.
Our survey said?
Oh, nobody said craps.
Crap.
Nobody said craps. Raise you the number one answer. Name a woman's name that starts with E. You said Esther. 21 people said it. You got the cash. Our survey said. Ellen, the number one answer. The most comfortable room temperature, you said? 72 degrees. You're 21 points away. Our survey said. 19. 70, the number one answer. It comes down to the last question. To name a bookstore chain, you said? Crown. If two people said Crown Books, you've got the cash. Our survey said. Yeah! They've got $5,000. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Vulgar party and families will receive a Hellbros watch for all occasions. Super accurate quartz watch, beautifully styled and easy to wear from Hellbros. Hoover's Spirit portable canister vacuum for powerful suction and incredible mobility. It's light enough to carry anywhere you clean from Hoover. From the Lee Middleton original doll collection, the First Moments Christening Awake doll, beautifully gowned and bonneted from Middleton Doll Company. For quick, quiet cleanup, Bissell's Double Brush Classic sweeps all floors, the perfect companion to your vacuum cleaner by Bissell. Pond's Cold Cream gets out dirt and makeup, soap leaves behind. Pond's cleans like no soap can. Fruit of the Loom underwear, quality and value in free shrunk cotton underwear. Fruit of the Loom, we fit America. From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.
Reptile.